Students of class 10, this is the fourth video related to the measure of central tendency and finding the median of the data. Just watch this properly so that you can find out your doubts and vary the points, what exactly you understood, what didn't understand, etc. You can go through properly, and if any more doubts, you can later you can give comment or you can ask whatever you can do. Quartile. Quartile, it is are those values of the variate which divide the total set of data in four equal parts. For finding quartiles, the given items or data are always arranged in ascending order of their magnitude. So you can see in the line drawn, it is shown, suppose A, B, the data, the range you have taken, middle Q2, that is your median. And if you look at this carefully, this is, seems to be 25%, 50% is your median, so the 24th or 1/4 of this, that is your lower quartile. And the other one, Q3 written, that is your around 75% or 3/4, that is your upper quartile. Okay, so it is the difference. So this is the middle quartile, lower quartile, Q1 is lower quartile, Q2 is median or middle quartile, and Q3 is the upper quartile. Okay, it is clear? You can see how to find out the lower quartile or upper quartile. For finding, first you find out the N. For finding quartile, you have to find the value of N. N can be negative or positive. We have earlier videos, we discussed already this one. If N is even, for N is, if you can arrange this ascending order, then find the lower quartile. The formula you have, N by 4 or N plus 1 by 4. N by 4 for the even terms, even value of N, N plus 1 by 4, it is the odd value of, written here at the end. N is if even, then N by 4th term. If N is odd, then it's N plus 1 by 4th term. For upper quartile, that is Q3, you have the formula for if N is even, that is 3N by 4th term, or for odd value of N, it is 3 bracket N plus 1 by 4th term. Is it clear? Okay. Next, again this formula is given for your understanding. If N is odd, lower quartile Q1 is N plus 1 by 4, the term. Upper quartile will be 3 bracket N plus 1 by 4, the term. If N is even, then lower quartile will be N by 4, the term. And the upper quartile will be 3 by 4, the term. Now, interquartile. Interquartile range, it is the difference between the upper quartile to the lower quartile. So, normally, as you know, Q3 is greater than Q1 because the upper quartile is the 3/4 and the Q1 is 1/4. Therefore, Q3 minus Q1 is your interquartile range. A simple question given to find out the quartile. Find the lower quartile, upper quartile and interquartile range of 9, 11, 15, 19, 17, 13 and 7. Okay, this is the question. Let us see in the next slide. You can see the data. First of all, first thing to do, sort the data in ascending order. So you can find out, this is 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19. So that after ascending, you can find out the number of data. N is 7, it is odd number. Okay, so N is odd number, the formula here to find out the lower quartile is N plus 1 by 4. So 7 plus 1 by 4, that is 8 by 4 is second term. Second term you can see, it is from left, it is given here 9. So the value of lower quartile is 9. Upper quartile, Q3, the formula, since N is odd, therefore 3 bracket N plus 1 by 4th term. So 3 bracket N is 7, so 3 bracket 7 plus 1 by 4th, that is equal to 6th term. So 6th term, you can see, it is your 17. So upper quartile, that is Q3, is 17. Therefore, interquartile range is equal to Q3 minus Q1. So 17 minus 9 is equal to 9. Okay, it is clear to you. I hope all of you understood. Now, another question, it is related to that of the group data. to find out also the lower quartile, upper quartile, and interquartile range. Question given, class interval 5 to 10, frequency 3, 10 to 15, 4, 15 to 26, 20 to 25, 9, 25 to 37, 30 to 35, 1. Let us see the next video to understand the next slide. In the next slide, you can see this one. The first cumulative frequency you have to draw by taking the cumulative frequency. You can see this one, 3, 4, 6, 9, 7, 1, and accordingly 3, 3 plus 4, 7, 7 plus 6, 13. Like that you can obtain 13 plus 9, 22, 22 plus 7, 29, 29 plus 1, 30. So last value is your 30. Next slide. To plot the graph by taking the class interval and cumulative frequency. So look at this graph. It is very clear to understand. Class interval taken on x-axis, cumulative frequency on y-axis. Therefore, it is plotted. You can see this is by taking all these values, lower quartile and upper quartile is shown. Okay, so it is here. Try to understand. After that, it is given. Since the value given last is 30, so we can 30 is the even number. Let us see in the next video how it is presented. Here, lower quartile Q1 is 30 by 4 and is even number. That was 7.5. 7.5 you can find from the graph. You can see on y-axis from 5 to 10, 7.5 approximately line is drawn, and accordingly it is coming after 15. Similarly, upper quartile Q3, that is 3n by 4, so 3 into 30 by 4, 22.5, this is 20, so 22.5 fifth term, you can see back, 22.5, you can see it is getting your, after 25, the value is approximately 25.5, so Q1 is equal to 15.5, Q3 is 25.5, therefore interquartile range is Q3 minus Q1 is equal to 25.5 minus 15.5 is equal to 10. Okay, I hope it is clear, all of you understood. Next slide, we have some questions to answer. If you understood all this and thoroughly watched the video, you are in a state to answer the questions given here. Here, first question, the marks obtained by 19 students in a class given below. So, data given 27, 36, 22, 31, 25, 26, 31, 24, 37, 32, 29, 28, 36, 35, 27, 26, 32, 35, and 28. Find the median, lower quartile, upper quartile, and interquartile range. Similarly, another question like that, you can go through and work out. Then, another tabulated data, age with frequency given, here you have to find out median. And the last question again, another tabulated data from which the data and frequency given, you have to find out the median, lower quartile, upper quartile, and interquartile range. Next, this is the last question for you. Here it is given, the group data for plotting this graph. You have to use the graph paper, plot this so that you can confirm. Data is given here, age, number of casualties. So 5 to 15 years, 6 casualties. 15 to 25, 10. 25 to 35, it is 15. 35 to 45 is 13. 45 to 55, 24. And 55 to 65 is 8. 65 to 75, 7. Construct a less than cumulative frequency curve for above data. Keep in mind, less than curve is also called cumulative frequency curve because it is always uprising curve. Taking 2 cm, the 10 cm, the scale. Similarly, on x-axis, 1 axis and 2 cm for 10 candidates in other axis. Form a graph and find out the median and the lower quartile. Dear children, the questions are very clear to understand. I hope it is clearly explained and clearly shown to you. Okay, if you understood this, you can share, subscribe, and if there is any doubts, you can give necessary comment for improvement.